Hello, my name is Chaba, and this is the texture we are going to break down today in Substance. The goal here is to create a really light-skinned female character. In light-skinned characters, the bruises and discoloration is much more noticeable, so I'm trying to emphasize that here. We're going to mainly focus on the layers, and you can see how it's structured up. This texture approach is based on J-Hill's texturing, which I do highly recommend if you want to know everything in depth, everything explained there from start to finish. I will leave a link in the description for this video and this channel. Well, that said, let's start. Here I colored every folder and we are going through one by one what they do and why would you need them. I color the groups for better visualization. So blue maps are for roughness, red, orange and pink will represent the different stages of the main skin shader. Greens are responsible for details, light green is for skin detail, dark green is for clothing. The undefined is not exported, it's just there for testing purposes. Okay, let's turn off all of them and start from the bottom. So this is how you start after you bake down all your maps. So first layer is a simple roughness base, so you can add it later as well, but it's important that it has to be the bottom one. It's just a simple rough material, you can see it's around 0.6 or whatever is worth for your character. Next thing is to create our first layer sets, which will represent a layer below the skin. They are simple fill layers with only color activated, as you can see it here. For all of them, I just applied a simple black mask and added a grayscale to all of them to randomize a pattern of flesh. It doesn't have to be perfect at all. Let me show you all of them one by one. They are very in size, shape, but nothing fancy at all. For the last one, I created a purplish color to represent veins and used a simple marble veins grayscale for that. Okay, this is it for the first layers. Group them in the folder. We don't need to do anything else here. Okay, next is epidermis, which will be the actual skin. Now the folder itself has a white mask. I will get back to it later why we need that. But first, let me show you what's inside the folder. So again, we are going to see a lot of fill layers again with black mask to create a randomized pattern. We are slowly getting into some details. Let's just turn it on so you can see it. This is what we will have. So let's start again from the bottom. Okay, first thing, a simple color variation with the grayscale. In my case, clouds. You can play with the balance and tiling, and also add another paint layer for the black mask, so you can paint some additional random shapes or textures. Next, again, same thing, different grayscale. The only thing you should watch out is that these first three layers in color should be close to each other with just really slight differences. You can always play with the layer's visibility scale as well to achieve the look you are looking for. Okay, the third one of this kind, the same thing, only difference is that I hand painted this layer and not used the grayscale. As I mentioned, we are aiming for a pale white skin color, so bruises can totally occur and should be occur. If you want more darker skin color, you should cover almost all of the dermis layer below. Okay, so this one is the same as the others, but this is for me, it's more like a fixing layer, both color-wise and to hide the bruises I don't want. Additional detail, nothing yet changed regarding the other maps, so no rough, nothing has been used this far, just simple colors. Next one is sun damage. It's kind of self-explanatory. It's a simple color again with black mask, but this one is a bit more crowded. Starting with a simple fill layer of noise, then variating it with some additional layers, and then blur them out to make it really subtle. So let's break this down as well. So the first fill is a simple noise. The next one is again a fill layer, but this time it's set to multiply to take away some of the details of that noise below. The next one is a fill again, but this time it's adding some details on top of that. And the next one is a simple filter, that is a simple blur. You can always play with the visibility if it's too harsh for you. Okay, so next one again is a fill layer that is responsible for the blackheads in the head area. But now we are starting to affect our roughness map as well. First up here was to create a generator that is using our curvature map. But we need to invert it. For that, go to here, polygon fill, select this one, and just simply select the whole mesh. Then we get rid of all of the curvature details, but with paint we are getting them back one by one. Let me just show you the mask itself. So as you can see, these little black dots in the skin area. Let me just show you the roughness so you can see that there is already a difference compared to our base. Let's go back to the material, and next one is freckles. Self-explanatory again. I will take down all of these two filters so you can see. With a simple paint layer, I just draw dots on the character's cheek and nose, and on her shoulder and on her back, where freckles would naturally occur on a light-skinned human. You don't really have to be precise with that, just play with it. So next I added a blur, so it basically acts like it's sending it underneath the skin area. So next one I added a warp filter, so it breaks up uniformness of the freckles, so it would look much more natural. And that is it for the epidermis, but I created a white mask, and now I'm going to show you why is that. So with paint, I just removed some of the areas where flesh would break through the skin naturally. Should be around the nose, the eye area, ears. The body part, you can see it's in the elbow bits, the knee bits. So basically that's it, that's why we did the white mask on it. So last one is eyelids. Now again, here we have few layers, but again, this time we are affecting the roughness and we are aiming for a really shiny surface here, because eyelids and tear ducts are really shiny surfaces of the character. I added a simple few layer. So for that fill layer, I added a black mask and just painted the eyelid area. For the second fill layer, I just added a color. It's not perfect, but if you check, realize there is always a discoloration going on at the tip of the eyelids where the tear duct appears. So that's why I added it. Okay, so next one is the details and extra. So again, let's start with the bottom. First, we start off with the redness. It's just a simple color fill layer with a black mask again. So if I turn down the invert and the paint layer, you can see that the first fill layer I used for the black mask is our thickness map. Then I added a filter because I want to invert this. And as you can see, it's the exact opposite of where I want the redness on the character. So filter and invert. And then I added the paint layer and fixed the harsh seams and added additional redness all around the character. As you can see in the shoulders and the back, which acts like a sunburn on the character. Again, it fits to the pale white skin color. I added redness to the knee pit area as well, for the eyes, for the ears as well. Okay, next one is blackheads on the body. Since I wanted to add a roughness, a different kind of roughness and actual height to this layer, that's why I separate it from the face blackheads. I want them to act like a hair follicle. I just switch to the mask itself so you can see where I added them. So again, where hair follicle would naturally appear on a woman's body, the tight on a pelvis area, on the shin, on the lower arm, and the armpits. So next one has a really special name. It's named a darkening body. It's basically, it does what it says. It's just a simple fill layer. For that fill layer, I painted areas where the body would naturally be darker. Next one is veins. I wanted to use a warp as well, but I ended up not using it because it just looked better. So again, this is just a simple fill layer. Here, select a greenish or purplish or bluish color for the veins, depending on your character's actual skin color. So in the mask, you can see just from my top of the head, I try to add where the veins would occur. Just a reminder that you should watch your references on where the arteries and other veins going in the body, so you can have clear visualization of where you should draw these. I also added some extra height for this, and I of course blurred it out to push it under the skin, basically. Okay, next layer is the tattoos. So this uses a color and a rough. So for that, I just used a simple paint layer for the black mask, and I just simply downloaded tattoo stencils and fix them if needed, so that I can just simply paint them here. And obviously use a blur so it's not that extra sharp. So it's named tattoo extra. This is just to show you that you can actually combine tattoos if you would like to. But again, I didn't spend too much time with it. I just wanted to show you that this is the way you should or can combine tattoos if you would like to. Okay, next one is moles and birthmarks. So let me show you the black mask. As you can see, it's just a simple paint layer, and I added moles where I think it's convenient. For that, I used a fill layer that has color, height, and rough. Just a little bit of height, and try to aim for a really rough setup. So this one uses a warp again and blur again. So this is for the details and extra stuff. Now let's go to the next one, which is the mouse. Let me show you the dark mask. Again, let's start from the bottom. Let me just uncheck all of this. Okay, so in this map folder, you can see that I have a simple V layer with the base color, but which represents the actual color of the lips. In my case, it's almost pure black. Of course, we should set the roughness really shiny. Okay, next V layer is color variation. That just gives an extra color variation to the mouse. Since I masked the whole mouse, the other parts are not important to us. So this one is crowded a bit as well, but nothing really special actually. You can achieve this with a simple paint layer as well, if you set the opacity a bit lower. As you can see in this color variation, I changed the roughness a little bit, and as obviously the color as well. So next one is recesses. This is actually responsible for the creases on the mouth pad. That's what we want to influence here. As you can see, it's extremely subtle regarding the color, because actually what we really want to achieve here is more related to roughness than color. As you can see, if I turn up the color, it doesn't really need that discoloration, or at least I doesn't need that. Next one is self-explanatory as well. It's just a simple fill layer inside the mouth cavity. The easiest way to paint that, if you have your character set up like mine, is to just go to the UV section and paint it right there. Okay, so next one is the nails. 90% of the time I actually use nails that are separated from the character, but in this case I leave it like this. It has a simple fill layer, so the folder itself has a black mask, and the nails and toe area were painted, so I don't bother anything else around the character. So I added a simple base layer here for the main color. For that you should go to extremely glossy kind of look. And for extra variation, I added an additional fill layer, which for I created a black mask, so we'll toggling X between white and black. I can simply take away or draw shapes on the nails, so you can create interesting shapes for it. Okay, that is it for the nails. Next one is makeup. So here we are actually using actual textures now. Let me just turn off all of them. So let me just show you the makeup folder's actual mask. So this was the area I was aiming for, so that's why I painted it like this. Okay, then I added a fill layer. As you can see, it's actually using a material. I find that this one is really close to an actual makeup glittery looking effect. So I use this one. At first layer, I created this purplish kind of color and play with the matte roughness variation. So for the next one, I went for a matte looking black. So again, I changed the matte roughness here, the grain intensity. I just play with it and see how it works. Next one is actually a really shiny area of the makeup, which again I use this texture, and as you can see, I cranked out the matte roughness, so it came out really shiny. Again, it's just using a black mask and a simple paint layer. The original design that I was looking for had that sharp edge, but I ended up not using it because I thought it's better without it. I just wanted to show you that if you just separate this stuff, it's much easier to remove them or add them if you need them. Okay, so next one, we are going to our next area, which is the clothes. So it has quite a few layers that again we are going to it one by one. To achieve this look, I used a paint along path on the actual mask of the folder Panty with the alpha of this triangle. I played with the spacing and the rotation. So all of them using a black mask actually. I will show you the paint height and why it's used here and what it does. But first let me turn on lace. You can see the first layer is using a simple material. It's a fabric cotton jersey namely. I just played with the rotation and a little bit of roughness. For the lace, I used 3D community assets from Adam Substance. I will leave a link down below for that asset if you need it. You can see for the black mask, the lace, I just paint it around the area where I would need it. We can go totally out of line with the painting, because at the exact folder we already created a black mask, so we can't affect the other parts of the mesh this way. Let me just show you the fabric. For the lace, you would not need the opacity, you just need to bring down this opacity mask, so I think it just looks better this way. But obviously you can play with these values as much as you like. But I found that this is the one that works really well. For stitches, again, I used paint along path. And if you look at references, you can see that they are using multiple kind of stitches. And also there are kind of hard seams as well. So this layer is basically nothing but just a simple height. There is nothing other than that. skin stitches, use only a color one, but you can go and use the height as well to get some actual depth, but I didn't use it. I forgot to mention this important part. So the height needed here to elevate the fabric parts, not the lace parts. If I wanted to elevate the whole thing, like at the bra, then I would need it above the folder itself. Okay, so next one is the bra. Okay, so for the bra, I use a smart material for the base. But as you can see, I already have some carvings here in my actual normal map from my high resolution mesh. So again, I just play with tiling. For the next layer, I added a pink fill layer, then added a black mask, then used the fill layer on it, and added a grayscale of simple stars, or whatever is work for you. There are a variety of different symbols, so you can achieve a really custom look this way. And this pink paint layer is put it inside another folder, which is called the upper part, which is obviously separated from the below ones. Again, this is using a black mask, so I can do whatever I want inside this folder, while not affecting the other parts of the bra. So next one again, a fill layer with the black mask, and these are responsible for the stitches. The second one, as you can see, is the zigzag stitches. The other one is straight stitches. And the third one is a different one. It's the hook or eye or whatever this is called in the bra. I believe this is what it's called. So it's using some height and some roughness, as you can see here. So to achieve this kind of height look, you should go to the folder's black mask, add an anchor point, then add a fill layer, for that fill layer add the black mask, and for that black mask add a fill, and at the grayscale you can select your anchor points. In this case it's the bra mask. And then, as you can see, this way you can play with the actual height of the given textures below. Okay, so next one is pure black parts. So this is just basically to cheat some shadows in really deep recesses, like the ears and the nose. Fill layer with color and roughness. Okay, so we are heading for the last one, which will be the roughness. But first, let me show you why we did the base roughness at first. So all the way through, we were doing this. We added different kind of roughness in different stages, as you can see in the mouth and other parts as well. We don't let it lose that great detail of roughness. So in this roughness folder, there's two fill layers using both a black mask, and one of them is set to really rough and one of them is set to more of a glossy look. So let me show you the first one. This is called a roughness corrector. So in this black mask, I painted areas where the whole body should be more glossy, as you can see in the palm area, in the inner thigh area, and the deeper creases, and also in the face. Lower back should be more rough compared to the other parts. Okay, let me show you the other one. So in this layer, as I said, I'm going to fix the parts where the skin should be more rough, like in the finger knuckles here, or at the elbow, a little bit on the lower back, the heel and the foot, on the knees, on the kneecaps. Here is an overlook of the full roughness map. It doesn't have to be perfect as well. That is it for basically for the roughness. And there is one final thing I like to add. Since most probably you will not import your eyebrows here, I usually like to add some kind of an eyebrow test for my character, or to be able to visualize more how the character would look. Just quickly on the actual deerdeck material, there's just simple fill layers with black mask and a little bit of variation with some veins painted all over them. Nothing fancy, nothing extra. So that's it for today. I hope you liked it, hope it helped, and see you in the next one.